In spite of the name, dust bunnies are anything but cute. They are complex mixtures of matter from inside and outside your home, like hair from humans and pets, insect remains, fibers, dust, and dirt. Yuck. And even worse, these microbial communities are surrounded by chemicals, making each dust bunny an ecosystem that not only looks bad, but that can actually do harm to humans and pets. Dust can contain up to 45 chemicals, including phthalates and flame retardants, and it can stir up allergies and asthma. So let's talk about some of the other chemicals of concern that may be hiding in the dust in our homes. First of all, antimicrobials. That's a nice word for pesticides because essentially that is what these products are. They kill living things. Triclosan is one example. It's unclear how much of the triclosan we find in dust actually comes from soaps or other products, but triclosan has been found in almost every dust sample tested worldwide. Triclosan is a powerful pesticide and also an endocrine disruptor that may cause changes in the human hormone system. And recent studies have linked higher triclosan exposure to increased sensitivity to allergens. Triclosan has been banned in soap products in the US and Canada, but the results of more than four decades of continued use of triclosan in a wide variety of consumer products are staggering. The US Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has detected triclosan in the bodies of more than 75% of Americans tested. Another chemical of great concern that may very well be hiding in your dust, the pesticide chlorpyrifos. A few years ago, the American Academy of Pediatrics expressed concern about allowing continued use of chlorpyrifos on food. The group concluded in a joint letter to the Environmental Protection Agency with this warning. The EPA has no basis to allow continued use of chlorpyrifos, and its insistence in doing so puts all children at risk. Here's why. Pesticide exposure during pregnancy can create adverse birth outcomes, ranging from preterm and low birth weight babies to congenital abnormalities and pediatric cancers. Some studies have found associations between early pesticide exposure and neurobehavioral and cognitive defects like lower IQs and even attention deficit disorder. Today, the use of this pesticide is banned in the European Union and some areas of the US with a full ban likely on its way. Even when we don't use pesticides or chemicals in our own homes, they can easily transfer in on our shoes, in our food, and on our pets. And once they are inside, they bundle up with everything else inside your dust. And that includes chemical compounds and fragrances that can leave residues on skin, hair, and surfaces. The terms fragrance or perfume on a label can actually mask potentially harmful persistent chemicals such as galaxolide, which is a skin irritant and also a hormone disruptor, and it's highly toxic to aquatic life. And there may be another powerful endocrine disruptor in your dust, lead. If you thought lead went away with unleaded gasoline and lead-free paint, well, those bans made a difference, but only affected certain product classifications. Lead is dangerous, especially to children, and skin absorption is a significant route for poisoning. The CDC has concluded that even low levels of lead in blood has been shown to affect IQ and academic achievement. So dust bunnies aren't harmless. Neither is the dust that may be on surfaces, your TVs, electronic devices, even your floors. Norwex has a solution to capture and banish dust and those dust bunnies wherever they may be hiding. Our dusting mitt grabs dust and will not let go. Our superior mop system picks up even the smallest particles. The versatile EnviroWand gets to hard to reach places to attract dirt and dust and hold them inside. Think of these tools as your partners to banish those dust bunnies and reduce harmful chemicals in your home.